everyone, it's Danny. So I've noticed some activity in one of my Cattleya's sheath, which is a reason for joy, but it's not quite what I expected. Anyway, this is the Cattleya in question. It's my very first Cattleya, supposed to be orange, but I'm really not sure. I've never seen it in bloom. And this is the sheath in question. So let's take a peek inside. Hopefully you will be able to see it. Right there. So it's really not what you would call buds, is it? It's just yet another sheath. Now, this is not really so common in the Cattleya world, but it does happen. It's rather frustrating because I would have preferred some buds. But sometimes Cattleyas produce a sheath within a sheath because of the multiple hybridization, apparently. So sometimes you might get these genetic anomalies in Cattleyas because this is a very complex hybrid, most probably. It's not a primary hybrid or anything. So sometimes you do get these anomalies. And it's really nothing to worry about, you don't have to intervene. You just have to wait patiently for the buds yet again. So yeah, I'm not sure how much I'm gonna have to wait. Not sure how it will develop. As far as I read, I'm supposed to expect some buds anytime, really soon. But who knows? Anyway, the Cattleya itself looks really, really good. Really like this pseudobulb. It's really plump. This is a new pseudobulb. And the reddish hint is due to very intense light and even direct sunlight. If you see this in your Cattleya, it's not a reason to worry. It just means it received enough light. But you just have to be careful because from this point on, it's very easy to burn the leaf of the Cattleya. So don't go any higher with sun exposure and bright light. Okay, thank you for watching. This is what I wanted to show you. The sheath within a sheath matter in the Cattleya orchid. Okay, if you want to see more videos, please subscribe and you can leave me any questions or comments in a comment below. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.